as I watch the sun descending and the birds fly home to rest, in the hush when day is ending, that's the hour when I feel blessed. Smoking my pipe, smoking my pipe, like a whisper through the cornfield comes a gentle evening breeze. At the doorway of my cottage I recall old memories. Smoking my pipe, smoking my pipe, those far off places beyond the blue, familiar faces.
Hello, brothers and sisters of the Briar, Professor Jeremiah, back with another To Smoke Every Blend. Today I have my Eric Nording pipe. I've had this one for quite some time. Now, I'm going to tell you, with this pipe, and I've found this to be the case with a lot of Nording pipes, they don't really pass a pipe cleaner very well. I'm going to show you with the pipe cleaner here. If you just stick a pipe cleaner in straight, you should normally get it all the way to the bowl. But not so, not only with this Nording, but I've found it to be the case with almost every Nording pipe out there. So, here's my little tip on this is, one, sometimes if you have that stubborn match up to the hole with the stem, you could just spin it and get it in there. Well, that's not working on this one. What I do is I come back and I put just a slight little bend in it. And that might even have been too much. Just a bit little bend. Stick it all the way in. And then I'm going to twirl it again, putting a little pressure. And you see right there it went in. And it's going to go all the way up. Just a little tip out there for some of you new smokers. I think most of you older guys know that. I love using pipe cleaners to keep my smoke dried out. And today's, it's not overly moist, but it's a little moist, and you're not going to get it dry out. Probably in the Sahara Desert, might get a little bit dry, but it'd be a bit hard. Now, today's blend is one that I've looked for a long time. And that's, I've looked for a nice rum flavored tobacco, and this one's it. This is so far at the top of the pinnacle of the rum flavored tobaccos that I've been looking for. I don't see how another one will be able to surpass this particular blend. So what am I smoking today? None other than Country Squire's Treasure Island. I'm not getting paid by Country Squire for this. Maybe I should. But this one is an outstanding blend. When I pulled it out a couple of days ago, I've had it now for probably about 3 or 4 months, and I just hadn't gotten around to smoking it. I was like, well, there's so many other things, and I really didn't even know what to expect. I think, as I've shared with you before, when I bought these samples, I wasn't even paying attention to what they really were. I picked up the samples, and I thought I'm going to let my first couple of smokes be my impression, and I'm gonna try to decide if I can pick out what it is. And this one, it was no doubt on the first smoke what it was. But what makes this outstanding to me is the rum flavor stays consistent throughout the whole smoke. Very few tobaccos have that consistent flavor throughout the entirety of the smoke, but this Treasure Island does that. It also smokes straight down to the ash, right down to the bottom. Now, I know you see me relight my pipe quite a lot when I'm talking to you. I was watching an old interview with Jack Hargreaves yesterday, and in that interview, the reporter says to him, he says, "Well, you keep relighting your pipe. You know, you do that all the time, basically." And maybe I'll put that clip in here. Jack has to come back and point out to him, "Well, I'm having to relight my pipe because I'm talking to you." That's pretty much how I feel here. If I was to shoot a video of me just smoking this, I would light it the first time, and you'd only see me probably light it one more time at the very end to get my money's worth greedily out of the smoke. A couple of you had commented on the little jet lighter here. There you go. I wish you could hear it. It makes a little pop. Did have a number of these for sale on eBay, ranging anywhere from about, I think, $35 to, I think, $85. Now, the $85 ones, I'm not going to buy one, but some of you might be interested, and I think it's a fair price, because they are new old stock, still in the box, still with the manual, everything right there. These are from the 1950s, and this one, when I got it, I didn't know if it was going to work or not, but I just filled it up with Zippo fluid and it's ready to go. And maybe if you wanted to see, I don't know, I really filled it up the other day. See, that's where this little brass tubing comes down in there. And then it's going to come back up here. So when it heats up, that, I guess, create some magic torch. Such a pleasant smoke. Gooey factor level 8.5. It's pretty gooey and it's not going to dry out. I remember a couple of years ago, a member of our community had some creme brulee and they shot their first video of receiving it in the mail, and they said, well, I'm going to dry this creme brulee out. And I was like, that is never going to dry out. And then the next day they come back, and they're like, well, I don't think it's changed. It's not going to change. And I don't think this Treasure Island is going to really dry out either. And I always give this tip, so some of you are hearing me repeat it again. When you have a very moist tobacco, and it's not going to really be one to dry out, just pack it loosely in your bowl. Don't pack it as tight as you would some of your other blends. I'll definitely be picking up some more of this. It is a wonderful blend, and I would put this at a 5. 5 out of 5 for me. Is it going to be an everyday smoke? Probably not, and the reason why is because it is so strong in its flavor, I just don't really think that I would want to smoke it all the time, and it might would wear it out. I'd kind of like for this to be a nice little surprise, either, you know, 2 or 3 times a week. That's how I feel about it. It's a, you know, you might have that favorite food, but you don't eat it every day because you don't want it to not be a favorite food. And that's where I think this Treasure Island from Country Squire is going to be a lot like that. Well, brothers and sisters, as you see, I'm kind of relaxed and laid back smoking this one, and I'm going to sit back here and finish it off. Still barely going. I can probably nurse it back to power. One thing, as I did say with this lighter, if you like using Zippo fluid but you don't like the flavor, and I know some of you guys say, well, I never taste it. Well, wonderful. You've already burnt that part of your taste buds out. But I don't taste any Zippo fluid at all by the time it runs through the jet. I can smell it when I first light it up, but once it's coming out of the jet, that flavor's gone. All right, brothers and sisters, well, I'll catch you tomorrow. Till then, God bless.
Should we sit down here? I'm going to thin up again,
right? Yeah. Jack, I know you've had years and years of experience of pipe smoking. One thing which baffles me is how do you manage to keep the pipe in your mouth and speak at the same time? What's the secret?
Well, I don't know. I've got it on. The fact of the matter is it takes a long time to learn to smoke a pipe. Which I'm a man who's a real pipe smoker. He never has to think about it, it's always lit. Most people who take up pipes take it up for some personality reason. worst of all the Americans. Americans, they don't smoke pipes, they wear them. You watch an American and he goes. You know he's not a pipe smoker as soon as you see him.
But you're forever lighting your pipe. Is this all part of it?
Not when I'm alone, it's just when I get disturbed.
Like we are today.